How do you guys feel about a late night wet hair vlog? Because I just took a shower at 1 a.m. and it's kind of far too late to be using the hair dryer, so I kind of just have to air dry. It's super weird. I usually don't wear my hair down when it's still wet like this. I like to tie it up while I do my face, like my moisturizer and all that stuff, and then just kind of let it down and immediately hair dry it. But yeah, this feels weird. Look at this. You can kind of see how long it is now. Barry. Here's a picture from last time I got it cut, whatever that was. And this is where we're at right now, from the top of my head all the way down to here. And that's just the front. The back feels like it's a lot longer, but my hair is also curly, so you don't really get an accurate representation. Thinking about straightening my hair one day. Like, I've asked my sister if she can do it, maybe on like a Saturday or something, so it's just straight for the weekend. Because I'm curious how long my hair is when straightened, because when wet, it's here. So I'm curious. And for those who may be wondering, I'm growing my hair out for just as long as I feel like it, really. I don't have a destination length. That's not the right word, but you know what I mean. I don't have a length that I want it to get to and then stop. I'm just letting it grow, because I've had long hair in the past, but I stopped letting it grow after a while. I got it cut. But now, I feel like my hair grows a little bit differently to how it used to, because my hair, well, I also treat it better than I used to. I used to back comb my hair all the time, so it would be all poofy. But now, as you can see, even when it, well, it's also because it's wet, but it's growing more down, a little flatter than it used to. It's probably healthier for my hair, so I'm not really complaining. So yeah, we're doing a recap vlog today, as I'm sure you've gathered. Today has possibly been one of my least productive days ever. And I said to myself at several points throughout the day, like, why aren't you doing anything? But I also just couldn't work up the motivation or the strength to get stuff done. And it sucks. I got up in time for, or I was awake in time for our Attack on Titan 2 co-op recording for Dan's channel. But unfortunately, poor guy fell down the stairs, so he was injured and couldn't record. I hope by the time this vlog is out, you're doing better, Dan. I really hope you are. You should be, I think. So we canceled that, and then I couldn't get the slots filled for my weekly series recordings, so those all got canceled. And I ended up just planning out a Mario Kart recording for tomorrow at 1 p.m. That's part of the reason why I showered tonight instead of showering in the morning, because I'm gonna be recording, like, or sorry, instead of showering right before leaving for work, because I knew that I wouldn't be able to get up early enough in the morning to shower. And I know that after I'm finished recording, it's gonna be like 1:30, 2 o'clock. I have to leave for work right after that. So I specifically showered tonight to circumvent that problem. Because, like I've said before, my hair gets tied up at work anyway. It doesn't really matter what it looks like, just as long as it's clean. So those recordings were canceled. Planned Mario Kart for tomorrow. And then, let me tell you, my ass has barely left that chair all day, and I've just not really done anything. I've done no editing, I've done no exporting, I've done no metadata, I've done nothing. I just have had a completely nothing day of sitting around, being lazy, watching YouTube, eating food, being tired, and just not doing anything. So it's sucked. I kind of hated it. I mean, I enjoyed stuff in the moment. Like, I watched some Game Grumps animateds, and I enjoyed those in the moment. But then I finished watching them, and I'm like, why have I just been sat here watching Game Grumps animate that I could have been working on stuff? Thing is, I didn't want to record because I really didn't feel like I would be entertaining or like I could produce a quality product. You never want to record when you don't want to record, because especially when with the stuff that I do, like, I'm a personality. My Let's Plays are me. I have a personality, and if I'm not feeling like myself, I'm not gonna wanna record, because it's gonna come across in the recording that I don't really wanna be doing it, and thus I'm not gonna do it.
I also streamed Bowser's Fury. I don't know how I forgot to mention this, but I streamed it for like 2.5 hours or something like that. So, yeah, I do not know how I forgot to bring this up, but that was a big part of my night.
Now, luckily, I do have one more day before my videos are set to resume, and I already have Wednesday's video recorded because I recorded an extra episode of Pikmin 3 like a week or two ago at this point. It was like just over a week. So Wednesday's video is set. I literally just need to do Almia for Tuesday, and then I'm set for another day after that, so I can just kind of chill or slowly work on other stuff. And also, we've planned a booster pack session for Tuesday morning, so hopefully that works out. We haven't done any booster pack this weekend or over this past week because we've both been super busy. I got called in for overtime, and today was Valentine's Day, so Zach is a married man. He spent it with his wife, like a good husband. And I spent it at home by myself watching YouTube. The two sides of the booster pack boys. So to say. Oh god, I look stupid. And then I've been talking to a friend of mine who got very upset when they found out that I hadn't seen the movie The Road to El Dorado. So I bought it on YouTube Premium and I'm thinking about watching it right now. I probably shouldn't because it's 1:30. Oh, hey. Cameron Stott texted me. Remember Cameron Stott from college? One of my bestest friends in the whole wide world? Who appeared on the vlog once in 2019 when I visited England? He texted me. It's actually kind of funny. I texted him at the beginning of the month because I found some videos that our college had uploaded. And I found videos literally with our teachers in them, and I sent them to him. I was like, look who it is, it's our teachers. Being very teacher-like, you know, it was, they're called lesson tasters. So like, Rob did one for the course that Cameron and I were on, and then Gary did one for the media studies course. It's a throwback and a half, let me tell you.
Hi, my name's Rob Chadwick and I'm the course leader on the Creative Digital Media Production BTEC course of Film and TV here at Huddersfield New College. Today I'm going to give you a bit of a taste of the kind of things that we do on the course and give you a bit of an overview of the kind of projects that we might do.
Hi guys, my name's Gary, I'm course leader A-Level Media Studies here at HNC. We're just going to talk you through a couple of our key texts that we look at throughout the A-Level course to give you a taste of what you will be studying when you come and join us on the course.
Yeah, I probably shouldn't watch that movie, but I think I'm going to anyway. Probably gonna fall asleep, but whatever, I already hit play on YouTube Premium or TV or whatever it's on, and once you hit play, you only have 48 hours to watch it, so I should probably do it. Anyways, folks, that is gonna be it for today. I'm really hoping that the morning is a little bit more productive than today was. If I can at the very least get that Mario Kart video recorded, I'll be happy, but anything, and Almia. Mario Kart and Almia, those need to get done. All they need to get done is be recorded. I don't need to edit, I don't need to do any of that. I just need them recorded so I can edit them when I get home. In fact, just edit Almia, that's all that needs editing. So we'll see how that goes. Thank you all for watching, stay tuned for tomorrow, and I'll see you guys then.